My name is Bob Pepin. I'm now a professor emeritus of physics, just retired. And during the Apollo missions, I had several roles. I think the first one was that we were one of the laboratories selected to analyze the lunar samples. And that was very exciting in itself. I can still remember picking up the very first samples from Apollo 11 at the Mission Control Johnson Space Center. And that was a very exciting time. Well, the significance was that we learned a few interesting things. One is, from our own point of view, the science we did here, we learned a great deal about the sun, which seems strange because we weren't going to the sun. But it turned out that because the moon has no atmosphere, the particles that are constantly being spit out by the sun's phenomenon we call the solar wind could impact the moon's surface directly without getting stopped by the atmosphere, which is what happens to them here on Earth. And they embedded themselves in the lunar dust grains. So when we first looked at the gases, which are more or less what we do here, that were trapped in these little particles of soil, we discovered that we had very large samples of the sun, not the moon. And so we learned a great deal about the composition of the sun by studying lunar samples, which seems a little bit ironic, but nevertheless, that's the way it turned out. The other thing that I think was perhaps most important is that from the composition of the lunar rocks that were brought back, it seemed very strange that many of them looked very much like the composition of the deep Earth interior, the so-called Earth's mantle. And this related directly to a theory that had been proposed a few years before, that in fact the moon was formed by an enormous collision of a Mars-sized object with the Earth when the Earth was only 10 or 20 million years old. And this spit off, or blew off, a lot of material into Earth orbit, which eventually condensed to form the moon. And so the moon is made up in part of material from the Earth, which is why we saw that similarity, and in part from the material from the projectile, the Mars-sized body that hit the Earth. The two coalesced, and the Earth got a little bigger, and the projectile, which was somewhat smaller, just disappeared into the Earth. And so we're actually a hybrid of one very large object, the Earth, and a somewhat smaller object that happened to get too close and hit. So that I think, in terms of the fundamental question of how we got the moon, what was the origin of the moon, which is a question that had haunted our field for many years, that essentially supported the theory of this giant collision, as it's called, and that the moon is actually made up in part of Earth material spewed off from the Earth in this collision. Well, it was a tremendous technological achievement. And from a political sense, it was also an achievement because the goal of going there and returning safely had been set 10 years before by President Kennedy. And unlike some things today where you state long-range objectives that never seem to be fulfilled, this one was. And I think it was because both the country and the technological folks who at that time really ran NASA were really hotshot young people, and they made it work. And to me, that was really an impressive achievement. As far as the landing is concerned, I spoke about that before. First step off the planet, that sort of thing. But from the point of view of the development of technology and making a commitment and keeping it within a time scale that had been specified is kind of a rare event, from an engineering and from a political point of view. So the whole thing was an enormous success. And that, I think, probably in toto, impresses me more than any single phase of the mission. It's just the totality of how it happened. I used to envy the old English explorers who were trying to find the headwaters of the Nile here on Earth. That was a big deal in the 1800s. So here's a chance to get involved in another exploration mission, and one that was totally unique in terms of what had happened before, because it was the first step off our own planet to another body in the solar system. And I think the fundamental significance of the lunar missions was just that we were able to leave Earth and go elsewhere at the beginning of a step outward in space. And you will see, I may not, but you will probably see a first expedition to Mars. And humanity will creep out through the solar system, finding resources, learning things. But the moon was the first step, and it was a big one.